Sunflower Hill Yogis yoga teacher Edie here. I hope you guys are all having a great day today. Thank you so much for joining me for our yoga class. We are going to be playing with a standing series using a chair as a prop. So if you don't have a chair, you're going to want to grab one. One from your dining room or your office is perfect. So press pause, grab your chair, and then come on back and meet me in your space. Great, so you have your chair. We're gonna get started with a posture called empty coat sleeves. So empty coat sleeves is less of a yoga posture and more of just a really nice way to warm up our spines and our legs and get connected to our body. We're gonna let our arms dangle by the side. So just shake out your shoulders, feel the weight of your arms. Maybe notice how your hands feel relaxed and give your hands a little shake. And then we're gonna let those arms just rest by the side and dangle. Feet are wider than hip distance apart. So take a look down at your feet. Make sure that your toes are in front of your heels. So that's feet are parallel to each other. And then we're just gonna gently begin to rotate the shoulders around, letting the arms be really heavy. And as you do, just gently bring opposite hand to opposite hip and lift the heel away from the ground. So you might notice that my heel is lifting as I gently sway. So this is called empty coat sleeves because it's almost like you're just kind of wingdinging your coat sleeves around. And then just find your breath, making sure that you're lifting the heels, so you're not hurting your knee. Nice. Just a few more like that. Might feel kind of good. Your shoulders might be relaxing. And then come back to center. Let those arms just drop. And then set the feet together, and we're going to face our chair. We're about 2 feet away from the chair. Feet are right under the hips. Knees are slightly soft. Let's inhale, sweep the arms up. Let the eyes look up. We're gonna find half sun salutation with the chair. As you exhale, bring the hands down. Hands to the chair. Soft knees. Let the head and the neck hang for our first forward fold. On your inhale, press into the chair with the hands, engage the core, find that nice flat back. Exhale, forward fold, let the head and the neck hang heavy. You can use that chair to help you find balance. Give the head a gentle nod, yes. Gentle shake, no. Engage the core, soften the knees, reverse swan dive. Arms up, let the eyes look up. Exhale, hands to the heart. Nice, beautiful half sun salutation with the chair. Let's inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, flat back, forward fold. Good, hands find the chair. Let the head and the neck hang. Knees are still soft for our second forward fold of sun salutation. Inhale, nice half lift. This time we're gonna straighten the legs a little bit and press the knees towards the back wall. You might really feel a nice stretch on the backs of the legs. Exhale, release, forward fold, head and neck hang heavy. Engage the core, find that flat back, sweep the arms up, reverse swan dive, the eyes look up. Exhale, hands to the heart. Nice, we'll do one more like that. Inhale, sweep the arms up. Just notice how your body feels. Exhale, nice flat back, forward fold. Hands to the chair, let the head and the neck hang heavy. Give the head a gentle nod, yes. Shake it, no. Inhale, nice half lift. Reach the heart forward. Exhale, release. And we're gonna keep the hands on the chair, and this time we're going to just gently bend one knee at a time. We're walking out the back, stretching into each leg on its own.
Notice your breath. Breath is the most important thing. Always pay attention to the breath and how the body feels with the breath. And then let both knees be sort of soft. Engage the core, find the half lift, and then sweep the arms up. Eyes look up, exhale, hands to the heart. Good, nicely done. Let's inhale, sweep the arms up. We're gonna add on. Exhale, nice flat back, forward fold. Let the hands come to the chair. Head and neck hangs heavy. Inhale, nice half lift. Good, bend the knees slightly. We're gonna find a cat. So as you exhale, round the back, tuck the chin in. The scare and Halloween cat. And then on your inhale, draw the heart forward. Press the tailbone up to the sky for cow. And exhale, nice scare and Halloween cat. Inhale, cow. One more, exhale, scared Halloween cat, press away. Inhale, draw the heart forward for that cow. And then let's come back to the neutral spine. We're gonna add a downward facing dog on. So let's step our feet back at least one footprint. When the feet step back, the hips shift back. Keep the hands on the chair so our arms are getting long. And then we let our ears rest by our biceps. Now this might feel like a really big opening in the backs of your legs. If it is and it feels a little bit too much, just bend the knees slightly and see how that makes your body feel. Nice long, easy breath in. Long breath out. Hold on to the chair, engage the core, step back up. One foot step up on each side. Find the half lift, reach the heart forward, and then sweep the arms up, eyes look up. Exhale, hands to the heart. How's that? We're gonna do that one more time. So let's inhale, sweep the arms up. Exhale, flat back, forward fold, hands slide to the chair, head and neck hang heavy in that nice forward fold. Inhale, half lift, heart reaches forward. Exhale into cat, round the back, tuck the chin. Inhale into cow, crown of the head and tailbone up to the sky. And exhale, neutral spine, step the feet back, shift the hips back, and let the ears rest by the biceps. A nice downward facing dog, head and neck hang heavy. Long, easy breath. Might really be noticing this in your shoulders. And then engage the core, step the feet back up, one footprint. Find that half lift. Good. Soften the knees, sweep the arms up, eyes look up. Exhale, hands to the heart. Good, nicely done, okay. So we're gonna take our chair and we're just going to move it maybe to the top of your mat. Or if you're not using a mat, just move it so that you're standing on the back side of your chair. We are about a footstep away from that chair. Nice. We're going to take our left foot and step that foot back so that both feet are straight. We're going to engage the core and reach our heart forward and just set our forearms down the ground. A posture called pyramid pose. So you might be really experiencing the backs of the legs here. We're going to keep that left knee a little bit soft, but imagine that you're pressing into your left heel and then ground down into that right big toe. If you would like, you can cross your forearms over the chair and let your forehead rest. And then on your inhale, engage your core. We're gonna bring the hands to the back of the chair. Lead the legs just as they are. Bend the front knee. Hands can stay on the chair or release the chair and sweep the arms up. And now you're in warrior one. A strong warrior position. And then, whoa, let's exhale. Bring the hands, if you lose your balance like I almost did. That's what the chair is there for. Straighten the front leg, bring yourself forward. Notice how the legs feel. You're going to take that right hip and just shift it back slightly so that left hip can come forward. The core is nice and strong if you would like. Forehead to the back of the chair. Both knees are slightly soft. You don't want to hyperextend the knees. And then let's find warrior one. Inhale, bend the front knee. Bring yourself up. Sweep the arms up. Exhale, bring the hands to the chair. We're going to pivot that back foot to a 90 degree angle. Bring that front foot forward and just take a look. Heel to arch of the foot alignment. Bring your left hand to your hip, right hand to the chair. Take a look down, make sure you can see your right big toe, and then reach your left hand back, your right hand forward. We're in a nice warrior two. Easy breath. Bring the forearm to the back of the chair. Bring the left hand to the left hip. Just gently bring yourself to the side. This is a modified extended set ankle. Firm the core, draw yourself back up. Reach the arms out, warrior two. And exhale, bring that arm down. Hand to the hip, extended set ankle. Beautiful. Inhale, bring yourself back up to warrior two. Bring the right hand to the chair. Left hand to the chair, pivot on the toes, and step that left foot up to meet the right. And then just gently walk out the knees. Take a nice easy breath. And then we're going to step the right foot back. Straighten that left leg. So we're finding ourselves in pyramid pose again. Really think about pressing into the right heel and draw that left hip back slightly. Reach the heart forward. Keep a nice strong core so that you have a nice neutral low back. Arms to the back of the chair or forehead to the chair. And then inhale, draw yourself up, bend the front knee, engage the core, and sweep the arms up, warrior one. Exhale, hands back to the chair, straighten the front leg, bring yourself forward. Option to stay right here or forehead to the forearms. Pyramid. Inhale, bend the front knee, hands to the chair, engage the core, sweep the arms up. Warrior one. And then bring the hands to the chair. We're going to send that back foot to a 90 degree angle. Good. Left hand is to the chair, right hand reaches back. If you would like, reach the left arm forward. Nice, warrior two. And then let's find extended side angle. Bring the forearm to the chair, right hand to the right hip. Nice, long, easy breath. Firm up the core. Draw yourself back into warrior two. Nice, long, easy breath. Inhale. Exhale. Hand to the chair. Hand to the hip. Nice, extended side angle. And then bring the hand back to the chair, pivot on the toes, step yourself back up. Nice. And then just step to turn to me. Inhale, let's sweep the arms up. Exhale, hands to the heart. You guys did great work today. Thank you so much for sharing your practice and your time with me. If you want, on Friday, we're going to be doing a Zoom class live. So check out our webpage. I hope you can join us. Have a wonderful day.